Hey guys, in this video lecture we will create post model. Now we need a way to store all the posts in the blog. To do this we need Django models. A model in Django is a special kind of object. It is saved in the database. As you know, a database is a collection of related data. This is a place in which you will store information about users, your blog post, etc. And we will use SQLite database to store our data. So each model is a Python class. Each attribute of a model represents a database field. Now let's create our first model, which is the post model. Open up the Atom text editor and in the models.py write class and the model name itself, which is the post. So to make the post class to act as model, we need to inherit the model class into the post class using models.model. So in the post model, first field would be the title field we'll use. And the title field would be the field type should be the char field type and having the max length set to 100. You can change set anything that according to your need. if we go back to the browser and search for the model field reference in the Django documentation, we have multiple various field options and field types available here. If we scroll down a bit, we have the field types as auto field, big auto field, and the one we chose is the char field for the title or the text input for the text. Then we have the date field, date time now, date time field, decimal field, the slug field. The other option is coming here is the slug field. And we'll use slug field here and set the max length to 120. Slug helps us to create some cool looking URLs. We'll see it on a later upcoming videos. Then we have the author field and it is linked with the user class, which is a built-in class using the foreign key relationships. The user class, which is the built-in Django class, and the related name is blog post. The author of this post is linked to the is using the user class using the relationship foreign key. Then we have the body section, body part, which is the models dot or the period we'll use text field here and set it to nothing because there will be no limitations in the content sections. Then we have the created field and we'll use date time field for this and set the auto now add to true here. Then we have the updated field, the post updated, when the post will be updated, and the model we will use the same date time field, but the attribute should be now auto now is equals to true. The main difference between auto now add and auto now is that if we look at the Django documentation in the date time field, the auto now add is saying that it automatically set to the field to now when the object is first created. This means when we will first create our post, the created variable is set to now. It will not be changed when we update it. Then on auto now is saying that automatically set the field to now every time the object is saved. That means every time when we update the or edit the changes in the post, this field will be changed to now. So this is the main difference between both of two attributes of the for the date time field. Then we have the status. The status is saying that either you make this post drafted or published. We will use models dot char field type again and set the max length to 10, and there is a choices field option, choices option available here or attribute available here, and let's say make a variable, put the variable here for status choices which will create now. Then but the default should be draft. Now it's time to create a status choices or complete the variable status choices here, and it will be the list of nested tuple. For draft we use small draft, you can choose anything. And for published, we'll use capital published. And the last thing is remaining is that we need to define a string representation of this model, which returns the title of this post, of the post, using self.title. So our post is post model or models.py file is completed for now. Now it's time to make migrations for this model. So to add our new model into our database, first of all we have to make changes in our model by using the command python manage.py make migrations blog. As blog is the application. Here name user is not defined, it is giving the name error. We have imported the user, we do not have imported the user as we used here. So it comes from the from django.contrib.auth.models import user. It will now not give us the error make migrations. So our create model post has been created, and if you can see in the migrations folder of that item text editor, we have the initial one initial.py file here, and id, title, slug, body, all the things are there. See, id is the auto field which Django will add by default when making the migrations. Now using the command Django prepared a migration file for us as here inside the blog application that we now have to apply to our database using python manage.py migrate command. So write python manage.py migrate. We are now applying the changes here. And we have successfully applied the changes. So our post model is now in our database. So see you guys in the next video lecture.